Hey guys, Coupon Supervised here, and today I'm coming at you with a mini vlog just to kind of check in and talk to you guys, kind of give you some info and feedback as to some things that I've been noticing and want y'all's input on. So I am on my way to the P.O. Box now to send off the first set of giveaway winnings. Because, of course, if you follow the channel for any amount of time through all of those milestones, I do several giveaways. And I don't like to advertise giveaways for the sake of gaining subscribers through the giveaway. Does that make any sense? I like to put my giveaways as secret giveaways. I explain to you what they are for and what milestone they are for. And I kind of do a little, you know, saying thank you and all that good stuff for the support and whatnot. But I don't put it in the title. I don't make it mandatory that you thumbs up the video or anything like that. I don't do those things because I like my giveaways to be for the exact purpose that they are. I like for them to be thank yous to those who have subscribed to the channel, for those that support the channel, support me and the community that we're building, and so on, for all the right reasons. I don't like to get people to join that community for the sake of winning something or the chance of winning something, because I mean, there's so many entries. Like, what are the odds that someone that's not there and doesn't want to be there really are really going to win anything? So it's kind of like a waste of time when they're in. But at the same time, whenever you have those accounts that go out and just join giveaways for the sake of winning something and never really care about the channel, they have a higher probability because they're entering more giveaways than, say, you or I, and they're most likely going to win something somewhere. Does that make sense? So I have been putting out my giveaways, and I've been doing them in sets of two, and I've been doing them in random videos. There is no way to know when I'm going to do a video. I mean, when I'm going to do a giveaway, and I just like it that way. I hope that makes sense, and I really do hope that you guys aren't getting discouraged if you don't win in the first or second giveaway, because there's a total of like 10 giveaway packages. So I mean, you have a good chance of winning something somewhere, especially if you're one of those that likes to watch the full video or watch to the end and so on, because that's typically where I put the giveaway. So that information I will share, but that's nothing new. It's not an inside secret. It's just kind of how I've always done my giveaways. But now what I want to talk to you guys is, or talk to you guys about, is commenting. So comments, it is getting harder and harder to respond to comments, guys. And I don't make bank because people keep on telling me you should definitely hire somebody at this point to you should definitely hire somebody at this point to do the work for you. And I don't know what you guys think this is. Like, I don't know. I completely and totally appreciate the fact that y'all think that I make so much money. It's not there yet. It's definitely not there yet. I mean, I'm comfortable with growing in the community and making whatever money I do make, but I have not at all started earning enough to pay people to do things. Like, I only have 60,000 subscribers. There's people out there that have 500,000 subscribers. There's, you know, millions of subscribers. That is not what this is. That is not. Now, granted, I am totally grateful for what I do have, and I am totally for growing slowly but surely. And I like building quality over quantity, and that will always be the focus on building the channel. It will always be quality people over quantity of people. So I don't mind. I don't care what my money or my income is on YouTube, but at this point, I cannot afford to pay somebody to respond. So what I wanted your feedback on is, YouTube has a thing now where you can go through and like love people's comment, because the thumbs up is liking the people's comments, but you can love it, and it puts my image in an icon with a heart under that person's comment. Now, what I want the feedback on is whether or not you guys can see that. So if I go through under one video and just hit the love button on everybody's comment to show you that I read it, and I do try to answer some questions. If there's a question that I haven't answered a thousand times in previous videos, because I can kind of gauge what I talk about in the information that I share with you guys, because everything that I do on the channel is with purpose. So if I can kind of gauge that, then I want you guys to let me know when I hit the love button on your comment. Does it give you a notification, or does it just show up under your comment and you have to like go look for your comment to see if I responded? Or, you know, like, how is it that they are sharing this information with you guys that I am loving your comment? Because I feel like that is so much easier if I could do like a multiple reply. Because even to go through and say, thank you so much for supporting the channel, I really appreciate it, thank you for watching, even if I copy and paste that, I have to go through and copy and paste it to every single comment, which is a lot more time consuming than just going through and loving everybody's comment. I hope I'm making myself clear. Let me know if you get the notification on me loving your comment. Let me know how you feel about me going through and responding to like really good questions. Yeah, I hope you guys aren't like, I know there's so many people that get offended by so many things these days, where if I even acknowledge the fact that I don't make that much money, people get angry for some reason and say, how dare you not hire somebody because you're making money regardless. I mean, it's just, that's a ridiculous logic, and it's a ridiculous perspective, and unless you're there, you have no idea what you're talking about. So if you're one of those that are offended, well, that's just one of those things that it's too bad. It's too bad. And I mean, it's too bad. So we've talked about giveaways. We've talked about comments. Now let's talk about live. Oh man. So YouTube now has the live option. How freaking cool is that? I am excited to play on YouTube Live. The only problem with that is I myself don't have a lot of quiet time in my house. And when I do, it's when I'm working and I try to keep Boogie occupied doing something else. But as soon as the boys get home, like, it's homework time. And that in itself for three elementary school children is very hard. And it's hard to balance homework time with mommy's gotta complete this work for the rest of the day, or to close out the daytime, along with, you know, tending to Boogie and prepping for dinner. So it's not easy. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is I want to play with YouTube Live. I'm excited to play with YouTube Live. So what do y'all want to see? Like, what would you like to see as my first YouTube Live video? Because I'm not a huge Facebook fan. Like, y'all know, I've been kicked off of Facebook I don't know how many times for trying to be a positive person. And those not so positive people that really don't like me always flag my account. So it's really getting annoying on Facebook, because unless you send in your driver's license, your, like, you know, your right hand and your first child, you can't have your account back because somebody doesn't like what you're doing. And that to me pisses me off, because I feel like that is not only infringing on your First Amendment rights, but it's also flagging you to be something that you are not, and most likely something that you stand against. So I really don't like it. I don't like Facebook. I do have a Facebook group for you guys. I do have a Facebook group for those of you who enjoy Facebook and know how to use it more than Instagram or anything like that. So yeah, I'm pretty sure I'll do a YouTube Live before I'll do a Facebook Live. It's just gonna be that way. So yeah, I don't know. I'm just really excited. I'm really excited. Now for the overall channel, guys, I am so happy with what we're doing in our community. And by our community, I mean the Coupon to Provide community, the people that can relate to me, the channel, the cause, the viewers, the subscribers, the people that comment and interact with the channel and things like that. I am so proud of our community. Also, the way you guys handle the trolls is pretty awesome. I mean, there's a few people that have, you know, been pushed to that point where they, you know, just go off on the trolls. But for the most part, we all conduct ourselves as adults and we are not offended by the trolls, but at the same time, we are not submissive to the trolls. And that is me all day. I am not submissive to nobody. Like, that's just not the American way. I am not submissive to nobody, especially somebody trying to trash a brand that I put my wholehearted effort into. I don't come on here and say, oh, this is a hobby, so if I fall off, you know, whatever, I still have life. Well, no, this is not a hobby to me. This is a responsibility to me. Now, not to, you know, talk down on those who it is a hobby, because you have that total right to decide whether or not YouTube will be a business for you or will be a hobby for you. I just feel like whatever you do choose it to be, you have to respectfully treat it as such. And for me, I do not say that this is a hobby because I work really hard on it. And I want you guys to know that I work really hard on it and I work really hard for y'all. I mean, like, that's like the whole point, right? So I am very proud of the growth that we've had. It is like the turtle and the, you know, the tortoise and the hare. It's slowly but surely growing. But the people that are here, like, if you could ever have a group of people to have your back in any situation, any, you know, doubtful situation, any insecure feelings of your efforts and things like that, this is the crew. I mean, you guys are awesome. And it's not even just to me. That's what I want other people to realize, like the people that don't comment or are shy to comment or feel like they are ignorant to a lot of things that they wouldn't be comfortable commenting because they feel insulted or anything like that. Guys, y'all are so awesome when y'all are able to jump in there and respond for me, because you know that it's really hard. Like, when I get to respond in comments, I'm like reading the dates because it's like by section. So I have to scroll down for like 10 minutes to get to the last responded to section. And it's like 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. And it's really, really hard to like keep up. But I mean, I try. And when I go through there and I see that you've said, you know, someone asks a question, they say, well, she has this or she does that. Or, you know, y'all listen and you answer other people's questions. And that is a tremendous help. Like, you wouldn't believe. Because it's a lot for me to remember a lot of these things and be able to direct somebody to that on top of answering the comments, because then I have to leave where I'm at to go find the information or the specifics and give it to them and stuff like that. So I just am amazed by your willingness and your ability to just jump in there and help. It is so awesome to me and I totally appreciate it. And I try to make sure that I say thank you for doing such a thing, because it really does make my job easier. Even if it is just one comment that, you know, someone's responded to, it really does help. So I appreciate that. All right, guys, so I am at the post office and I'm going to go in there and send off these packages and see if I have anything in my PO box. And Boogie, you want to come say hi?
Yeah.
He's gonna get out of his seat really quick. Say hi. Say hi to the peoples.
Oh,
say hi, peoples.
Hi, peoples.
Come on, we're gonna go drop this off.
Okay.
All right, guys, so I'll see y'all in a little bit. Okay, guys, I don't know if y'all hear that, but it's a big reason why I haven't been able to do videos during the day lately. These guys have been working on our patio cover. So excited. I cannot wait for it to come together. I'm gonna show you guys how far they've gotten so far. Well, I can show you from my window up here, of course, but I can't show you what's downstairs. They have a lot of stuff going on out there, so can't go out there, but let me show you what they have done so far. Look at that. Oh my gosh. It's all that, and then it goes out to the side all the way over there. So awesome. I cannot wait for it to be done. So excited. Okay, so I'm home now, as you just saw. My house is fairly dark, but lighting is looking okay right now. I just recorded all the little video clips of the stuff that I bought from the 99 Cent Only store. And as you can see, I have a lot of it out and on the counter still. And then there's like bags on the floor and stuff that I gotta get put away. But I just thought I would bring you a quick vlog today. Like, I don't really get to talk to you guys and just, I don't know, be normal, be just me. The boys are about to come home. I'm about to make Boogie a banana milkshake. He loves those. I know he's gonna love that. And I have a few plans for Valentine's Day. So I might work in like a few days of the vlog into one video and just kind of show you clips and pieces of here and there of what we're doing or what I'm doing. The hubby doesn't have any clue that I'm gonna decorate and stuff. I have a small special dinner planned because we don't go out on Valentine's Day. It's just too much of a headache. And we rather enjoy our time like together as opposed to waiting for an hour and a half in a restaurant and stuff like that. So I'm gonna decorate here at the house. I'm gonna have a special little dinner. It's gonna incorporate cranberry sauce, which he absolutely loves. He's like a cranberry sauce addict, like eat it straight out of a can kind of guy. And yeah, and I'm gonna have like balloons and streamers and chocolate covered strawberries and some little sweet treats and stuff like that. So none of them have any idea that I'm setting that up for tomorrow. So super excited to do that. Hopefully he doesn't call me and be like, hey babe, I'm gonna work like 4 hours overtime, because that would suck, right? Like, that would just suck. So I'm gonna have to make sure he makes it home in time. At least tell him, hey, I'm gonna make a little dinner tomorrow, so make sure that you're home on time. I'm not gonna tell him about the decorations and all that good stuff. So yeah, that's where we're at right now, and I guess I'll just share something else with you guys whenever I come across something fun or with a point to share.
Hey guys, so it is Valentine's Day. I have started decorating for the hubby and the kiddos when they get home, and I really like the way it's coming out. Now again, they don't have any clue that I am doing anything, which isn't anything big, but it's definitely something for us. The hubby surprised the boys this morning with some Valentine's Day goodies that I have incorporated into the decor. So it's pretty simple. I took the 99 Cent Only Store streamers, hung them, and then I made balloon clusters and hung ribbon from it and some of the Dollar Tree LED lights, which are adorable. You can see I've done that in multiple places. And the table setup has the little pets that the hubby got for the boys, along with a large plate, a paper liner, which is this one here, and then this small plate on top. I have to put those up. And inside I put the chocolates that he bought them. I put three chocolates, the cherry chocolates, and the little chocolate candies in there, and layered it on the plate and added a stick heart to each one of their little characters. I think it's looking adorable. Did the same thing for all of them, and the hubby doesn't have a little pet, so I gave him his card with the heart attached. I have my Woodstock sitting over there, and I have prepped some chocolate covered strawberries with some of the peppermint bark chocolate that the hubby gave me this morning for my Valentine's Day treat. And I have one thing I like to do is take the gift bows. I don't remove the backing. I just tape the paper streamer together like that so that they kind of sit side by side each other, and then I stick it up with a thumbtack to the ceiling, which is how I do all the other ones as well. And you can see that the little bow adds a nice look so that when you look up, it doesn't just look like a thumbtack or tape. It looks actually nice and put together. And I put the balloons with the streamers and the lights, and I did another one over there, so it's kind of everywhere. These were the 4th of July clearance lights from, I think, the Target Dollar Spot. I got them for like 30 cents and they were $3, so that was cool. And I figured since I have boys, they're not gonna pay attention to the fact that there's blue, and you can't really tell anyway. It kind of looks like a white light theme. I took this streamer from Target Dollar Spot, wrapped it with one of those lights. Really adorable. They're all battery operated. And then here I took the paper doily hearts, taped them to each one of the little light bulbs, and hung them from the ceiling over the table. And you can see over there, I wrapped the battery pack, which you wouldn't even notice, around the light fixture on the ceiling. So that's what I got going so far. And we'll see what they think about it whenever they get home. I do have it coming all the way through the kitchen. Everything that way is pretty much cleaned up and set up. I just gotta clean up my mess here from making the chocolate covered strawberries and just making Boogie some lunch. I love it. I think it's looking really cute, and I think they'll enjoy it when they get home.
Alive.
Mom.
Oh, please don't walk behind me, come trip over.
That's a raindrop.
What, baby?
No, it wasn't a bird feed on you.
Seven shoes in that guy.
Alright, so kids are in distress. Let's see. No, I was gonna say, let's see how quick we can get to them. If they need that.
Now you gotta fight it.
Boogie took off.
Look at that. Valerie's like, what the hell? I'm gonna run too.
Well, you wasn't raised in the hood. You don't know about that. You ain't about that life.
Hey, babe.
Yes.
Why my old son cut me off?
I saw that. Come, Boogie.
Peppers. If Peter Piper picked a pick of pickled peppers, where the pickled peppers Peter Piper picked.